Hello, I'm Miriam Larici.
I'm Leonardo Barrionuevo.
On this video, we're going to talk about pronunciation for 22 very important figures in tango.
So before we start, if you are new to the channel, make sure to subscribe to it and activate the bell for notification and leave the comments if you have any.
Okay, the first one is caminada, to walk.
Salida básica, basic step.
Ochos, figure 8.
Cruce, to cross.
Cruzada, to cross.
Cruce and cruzada means the same. Sacada, to remove.
Barrida, to sweep.
Llevada, to carry on.
Boleo, whip.
Amague, fake movement.
Colgada, it's when you hang off axis.
Volcada, to lean towards your partner.
Cunita, rock step.
Parada, stop.
Giro, turns.
Molinete, windmill or grapevine.
Resolución, resolution.
Cierre, to close.
So, resolución and cierre is the same thing.
Punteo, to point.
Baldosa, square step.
Media luna, half moon.
Ganchos, hooks.
How did it go? Were you pronouncing correctly all of them? Or which one was the hardest for you? Let us know in the comments below.
Now let's give you a little explanation of each one. Caminada is to walk.
Salida básica is the very, very main step in Argentine tango.
Ochos is the figure 8, when the follower or leader do the step crossing front or back.
It can be front ochos or it can be back for ochos. Cruce and cruzada, which is the same, is to cross mainly in the basic step used by the follower, getting the cruzada position and replacing the body weight to keep going with the other leg.
Sacada is a displacement, so one leg will push off the other leg.
Barrida, to sweep, is when the leader or the follower catches the foot of your partner and drag on the floor without lifting from point A to point B.
Llevada, I'm using an Argentinian accent. Usually it will be llevada, but in Argentina we pronounce llevada. It's to carry on. So one foot is going to push or lift one foot off the floor and place it again down.
Boleo, the whip, it can be a front boleo or a back boleo, and it's when the leg goes around and bounce back or forward, to the position that it was before. Amague is a fake movement, and again, can be front or back, and it's mostly like a little cruzada in front or behind of the base foot.
Colgadas, this is when usually the woman is hanging, is moving off axis, and volcada is when we lean on each other. We go in off axis, but against one to the other. The difference is one is going out, colgada and leaning, and reaching the partner is volcada, volcada.
Cunita is a combination of rebotes, rock step in English, normally going front and back, bouncing, and most of the time, adding a little rotation to that, so it's like a cradle. Parada, to stop, not empanada, this is for you, Mir, if you're watching. So parada is to stop, normally from the leader or from the follower, to place the foot in front of our partner's foot so they encounter a stop. They need to stop before going and passing over that foot.
Giro is a turn. So sometimes we have both rotating. Sometimes the leader is the center and the follower is doing giro around the center. And sometimes the follower is the center and leader goes around the follower. So all the situation of turning is called giro. The step she's using or he's using to walk around the center is called molinete. Molinete is a windmill, so it's a step front, side, back, side, front, side, back, side. that we use to turn around the center.
Did you know that molinete and giro was not the same thing? Let us know in the comment below if this is new for you.
Yes.
Resolución en cierre. If you notice, in Argentina we pronounce a lot the R. Cierre en resolución. So it means to close the step. Whenever you finish the figure you were doing, you go almost like parking a car, front, side, and feet together. And for the follower will be back, side, and feet together. And it's to end the figure.
Punteo. Punteo is an embellishment, an adorno, that you can use with the big toe point on the floor. Usually the timing is in syncopation, so we go end one. End one. That's punteo. Baldosa. Baldosa is a square step. So usually we walk front, front, side, back, back, side. We make a square in front of us. And this is baldosa. It's also called the box or the tile.
Media luna, half moon. It is to go from one side to the other of the lid, not in a round movement. It is a little more square, almost changing lanes, making a U-turn. That is called media luna. Make sure to check the video we did recently comparing giro and media luna so you know more about this topic.
And the famous ganchos. Ganchos, ganchos, ganchos. We followers love ganchos. And ganchos is when you wrap with one leg the other leg. So it could be fast, in syncopation, gancho go. Or it can be a little slower and will be more like wrapping. But ganchos is a nice figure. Usually we have to do a lower if we are at the milongas. And if we are performing, we can do higher ganchos.
Make sure to pronounce ganchos, not nachos, like one of the judges in So You Think You Can Dance was pronouncing, not nachos, ganchos.
So that's all for today. Hope you can practice all the names. If you have a class with Argentinian teachers, then you can know the real name of all the figures and the steps. Also, it will help you if you go to Argentina and take classes over there.
If you are enjoying these videos, make sure to subscribe and like this.
If you have questions, you can write it on the comment below. I hope to see you on the next video.
Bye. Take care and stay safe.
Bye.